Hi friends, hope all are doing great. I'm sure you all agree that at one point of time we need a change, and that's why we either go on a holiday, which we can't do nowadays, or bring an interesting twist in our culinary style. In an effort to uplift the routine breakfast moods, my culinary expressions brings to you an interesting fusion expression, that is the wondrously spiced chili paneer parathas, or the Szechuan paneer parathas. Szechuan paneer parathas are an adaptation from the Punjabi paneer parathas, in which the parathas are stuffed with paneer or Indian cottage cheese that has been perked up with some Indo-Chinese ingredients such as homemade Szechuan sauce, spring onions, soy sauce and vinegar. Lots coming up ahead, tips, options and whatnot. But before that, friends, if you're visiting this channel for the first time, then hit the subscription button right away and press the bell icon to receive notifications about my uploads. And to the rest of my dear friends, do continue to show your support and zeal by your likes, feedback and shares. Now let's get started. First, let us have a look at the ingredients for the stuffing. We need 150 grams of paneer, that is Indian cottage cheese. It could be homemade or store-bought. 1 cup of onions finely chopped, 2 sprigs of spring onions finely chopped, 1/2 cup of capsicum finely chopped, 1 teaspoon each of ginger garlic finely chopped, 2 to 3 teaspoons of homemade or store-bought Szechuan sauce, 1/2 teaspoon of soy sauce, 2 green chilies finely chopped, 1 teaspoon of vinegar, 1 tablespoon of cooking oil, salt and black pepper powder, adjust according to taste. You are at full liberty to adjust the ingredients according to your individual preferences. I shall soon update the link in the description box for a detailed recipe on my blog, mycollects.com. Now firstly, we will heat oil in a pan. To this, we shall add the finely chopped ginger and garlic. Saute nicely. And thereafter, we shall add the chopped onions. Continue to saute well. Work on medium flame. You can also add the white parts of spring onions. Then add the green chilies and saute again. And after that, add the capsicum. Continue to saute. Do not leave the pan unattended. Add the salt. Once you add the salt, water starts oozing out. Make sure that you dry all the water. We do not want a soggy stuffing. And now time to add the vinegar, the soy sauce and the Szechuan sauce. You can buy the Szechuan sauce from the market or you can make it at home. There are videos on this channel on how to make homemade Szechuan sauce or the hot chili garlic sauce. You can have a look at them. In fact, it is smart thinking to keep some stocks of homemade sauces and cooking paste ready, such as coriander masala paste, tamarind sauce and mint and coriander chutney. Believe me, it will save you a lot of trouble. Now crumble the paneer very well and add it to the pan and combine everything. Mix well so that all the spices are incorporated well into the paneer. Remember to squeeze out all the water from the paneer before you crumble it. Even as you put the paneer into the pan, you'll find some water oozing out. Add the black pepper powder and the spring onions. give it a mix. Work on medium to high flame so that the liquids dry up. And that's it. You're ready with the stuffing. And now keep the stuffing aside to cool. Do not cover it while it is hot, otherwise again it will become soggy. Once it cools down, you can cover it. And now here are the ingredients for the dough. This is a multi-purpose dough. Well, how is it multi-purpose? Watch ahead to know more. The ingredients are 1.5 cup of whole wheat flour, 1/4 teaspoon of Nigella seeds, that is Kalonji, 1/4 teaspoon of carom seeds, that is Ajwain, 1 teaspoon of dried fenugreek leaves, that is Kasuri Methi, 1/2 teaspoon of chili flakes, 1/2 teaspoon of oil for shortening plus more for the parathas, water to knead, and 1/2 teaspoon of salt, or you can adjust according to taste. To make dough for the parathas, take flour in a white bowl. To this, add the Nigella and the carom seeds, as well as the kasuri methi and chili flakes, and salt. Also add 1/2 teaspoon or 1 teaspoon of oil, and then combine everything together. Knead the dough using water. Add water gradually. In the end, you should get a smooth and firm dough. Remember, since the stuffing is soft, so our dough also should be somewhat soft but firm. It shouldn't be very hard, it shouldn't be very soft, otherwise the stuffing will tend to come out while rolling the parathas. Once you've kneaded the dough, just dab it with oil. This is a multi-purpose dough because you can use the same dough for making masala puris. You could also use for making other stuffed parathas. And now, to make the stuffed parathas, take each ball, roll it halfway, and then apply a little oil in the center only, and then place 2 tablespoons of paneer filling. Applying the oil in the center is an optional step. Now bring up the edges together and pinch them to seal. Then sprinkle some flour and roll out the paratha. Be very careful while rolling out. Do not apply a lot of pressure. The reason for applying oil in the center is so that while rolling, the stuffing does not come out. Now the paratha is rolled out and we'll warm a skillet. Apply a little oil on it and cook the parathas. These parathas are quite healthy because it has whole wheat flour and paneer. Paneer, as you know, is rich in calcium and protein, and whole wheat flour has fiber in it. But remember, avoid using a lot of oil, otherwise the good qualities of the paratha will be overshadowed by the fat. Once the paratha is done from both the sides, then transfer onto a plate and repeat the procedure for the rest of the parathas. And then enjoy these warm parathas with your friends and family, along with vegetable bundi raita, or even the raw turmeric pickle, which is the instant pickle, or you could even have with a glass of mint lassi. These parathas would be enjoyed by children also, but you can make them a little less spicy by cutting down on the amount of green chilies and the Szechuan sauce. Friends, I hope you enjoyed this expression. Thanks for watching. Do not forget to like, share and subscribe. Very soon, I'll be back with another interesting video. Till then, goodbye.